morning, YouTube. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to probably the last episode of the bikini prep series. Obviously, we are post-prep. We are 3 weeks post-prep. But today is going to be a little bit more of an informative video for you guys alongside a bit of fun. So where do I start? I don't want to keep this intro too long, but first of all, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Olivia and I'm a bikini competitor, online coach and posing coach. We are about 3 weeks post prep now. If you've watched my previous video, which I highly recommend you do, I talk about everything that's been kind of going on and all the health issues we've had post prep and all the measures we've had to take to try and work around them. So quick summary, things have been a little bit rough post show for me, or post prep. With GI issues, we've been to doctors, we've taken meds, and we've even resorted to a 24-hour water fast, which I did in the last vlog, so make sure you do go back and check that out. But in a little summary, I thought I'd tell you how it went in this video, and I think alongside the laxatives, alongside the medicine, trying to reduce stress, reducing cortisol from taking 3 back-to-back rest days, and the water fast, things have actually started to move. I am feeling much better. Which brings us to the perfect time for this to be happening, because today we are having our first off-plan post-prep. We are going out for food today with my family, which I will include in this vlog. But before I do so, I do want to talk to you about reverse dieting. So that is something we're going to do, not right now, because it is a crazy busy Saturday morning for me. I have gotten up at 5 a.m. on a Saturday. I've checked in with my coach. I'm going to insert my check-in somewhere here. We are looking a lot tighter. The midsection is finally coming down. The inflammation is finally coming down. What I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a comparison of last week to this week, and you'll really see the difference in my GI area, my stomach, my gut, because we did establish it wasn't a stomach problem, it was a gut problem. But I just think my body just took some time getting used to not being in a prep, you know, lower cardio, higher food. And after 6 months of doing that, or being in such a restrictive caloric deficit, and obviously high cardio and high fatigue in general, I think my body was just taking a bit of time to adjust. But really, really happy. I am not in pain anymore. Still a little bloated. Things aren't still as regular, but we're definitely on the mend. It's been getting better and better every day. So I'm feeling very, very hopeful. And it just makes me feel a lot more positive about what's happening today. But yeah, I've gotten up at 5 a.m. I've checked in with my coach. I have done my 20 minutes of cardio because I am on 6 times 20 cardio. So I usually do it fasted in the morning on my spin bike before work. And I've also just been sat here for an hour studying. So this brings us to 7 a.m. on the dot, which is very good timing. It's exactly how I planned it today. You know, I am a time management queen. But yeah, if you don't know, I am studying the J3 University Bodybuilding Coaching course, and it's going really, really well. Obviously, I don't have as much time as I'd like to dedicate to this, because I do work a full-time job. I do have to train after work. I have my online clients and I also have my posing clients. So, you know, if I dedicate an hour to this a day, that's probably the most I can dedicate to it. Obviously, at the weekends, I try to do a bit more. But this weekend is just very, very busy. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to leave you here. We're going to get into all the technicalities of reverse dieting a little later today. Before we go out, but first we need to get a leg session in, because we are on 5 training days again, from 4 to 5. And just because we are going out for food today, just because we are out of the house all day, just because I have a lot of work and a lot of study, doesn't mean I'm going to miss my training session. And that has been a big thing for me post show, which is adherence to food, adherence to my cardio and training protocols. And things have gone really, really well. You know, 3 weeks adherence has been 100%. I haven't gone a gram over or under with food, even with everything going on with my stomach and the stress. I didn't let myself fall back into old habits and, you know, using food as therapy. So I have a little plan for today, for today's video, because I don't want to keep it super long and I don't want to ramble on for a very long time. So what we're going to do today is we're going to talk about reverse dieting. I'm going to tell you what it is, why we do it, why it's so important after being in a dieting phase and a contest prep, how long it usually lasts. Obviously, that is dependent on competitors and individuals, but I'll get to that. I'm going to tell you how I go about it, how it has been going, and most importantly, how it's been comparing to my other reverse diets. So this is my third reverse diet now. So I definitely want to do a little bit of a comparison and why this one is so much better in a way, but why it's also more difficult in a way. And what I'm also going to do as a little bonus tip at the end is I'm going to tell you what not to do in your reverse diet, what not to do post-show, just to set yourself up for the best reverse diet you can have and the most productive off-season you can have. But first things first, 7 a.m, the gym opens at 8, so I need to get my pre-workout meal in and go train some legs. I don't know if I'll bring you because I am very limited on time. I might just bring my camera with me. I might film a few of my top sets. We'll see how we get on. I might just show you my pre-workout meal there, and I might just mention what I do with nutrition around having off-plan meals as well. And that is also something that's going to be included in the reverse diet part of this video, because it is really important how you manage your off-plan and untracked food in a reverse phase. And as I said, I'm also going to bring you along to our off-plan, 3 weeks post-prep, finally being able to go out for food with my family and really celebrate what we've done this year. So I'm definitely going to bring you along. I'm going to show you the Christmas market in Galway here in Ireland. So our plan is afternoon tea, then we're going to go down the markets, and then we're going to go out for dinner. So it's going to be an amazing day, very busy day, but an amazing day. So I might just show you my pre-workout meal, and then I shall catch you either at the gym or when we're having a sit-down chat. And make sure to like the video, comment, share with a friend, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss my future videos, and make sure you do head over to Instagram. Follow me there because I literally document my life over there. So it's not my usual pre-workout meal, but I've kind of just taken the freedom to macro track. Peep the cute reindeer roll. We've got 40 grams of cream of rice from Train by JP in chocolate peanut butter flavor, which is my favorite. And then we've got some IsoPro from Train by JP whey based. I actually have two flavors. I have the Biscoff one and just the plain vanilla. 50 grams of berries. We got 6 grams of peanut butter and 6 grams of protein spread. And that is something I'm going to really quickly touch on because I am going to talk about it again. I need to train before we go for our off-plan meals, and performance in my gym sessions is really important right now. So I do need to fuel my sessions. But even if I wasn't training, you need to eat before you go out for your off-plan food. That is a mistake I used to make all the time. I would starve myself during the day and then go absolutely ham on food, eat way too much. So this is what we're doing today. I am fueling myself pre-workout, and I am going to have a post-workout meal. It is going to be a little bit on the lighter side compared to my normal meals, but I don't want to go into my off-plan stuffed either, but I don't want to go into it starving. So that is the approach we're taking. But as I said, all of this will be covered a little later, so I'm going to eat this, get ready for the gym, and a leg session at 8 a.m. pending.
Well, I still don't know what to wear. So I thought I'd chat to you first. First of all, let's just appreciate. I keep getting better and better at this. Very happy with the makeup. But I'll be gracing you in my boyfriend's robe. First of all, I had an amazing training session today. I have to say, I did not expect it because I'm just not used to training 5 days anymore. Like, I've trained 4 days for the majority of prep. So upping it to five was a bit of a challenge, but I think it was the strongest session of the week, if I'm being honest. But I'm going to dive straight into it because I don't want to keep this video super long. And obviously, I want you to stay with me until we go out for food. But yeah, got my notes. The topic of today's video, reverse dieting. First of all, let's just start at the very beginning and let's talk about what reverse dieting really is. So let's look at it from the point of prep first. So in prep, you are gradually doing everything. You are gradually lowering your caloric intake. You are gradually increasing your cardio. But then you are stuck in a time period of severe calorie restriction, very high energy output with cardio, with training, and eventually your body starts to see this as a norm. So yeah, you're pretty much a stressed body is now the normal thing. Low food, high cardio, high fatigue, low energy levels, that is just a normal thing to your body right now. It doesn't know how to operate at any other level. But with that, your metabolism also slows down. So let's kind of look at that example. Average female, let's say my height, 5'5" or 166 centimeters, a body weight about, let's say 52 kilos. I was lower on stage, but let's say 52 kilos. My BMR, or my basal metabolic rate, which is the calories your body needs just at rest, just to keep you functioning, keep the organs functioning, keep you alive. Let's say it's 1200 calories, for example. Now, as that body weight drops to, let's say, 49 kilos, which is what I was on stage, my BMR is also going to drop because my metabolic rate is now lower. So your body is pretty much trying to conserve as much energy as possible to focus on the primarily functions of your body, you know, making sure your organs are functioning, first of all, making sure you're alive and making sure when you go to sleep, you wake up again. So yeah, it starts conserving energy as you give it more energy and as you're expending more energy, it starts to conserve as much of it as it can. But at the same time, your body becomes like a sponge. So let's say post show, if you take like a week of just eating shit and eating crap and eating a lot of food, your body will not respond to that like a normal person body would. You know, if somebody goes on a holiday and eats a lot of food, they probably come back a kilo or two heavier and it's fine. Whereas post show, where your body is so sensitive, where it's literally like a sponge, it will absorb everything because it's been deprived for so long that, you know, it gets these influx of calories and it's like, okay, she's gonna starve us again. We need to hold on to this. And this is why you see competitors oftentimes putting on like 10 kilo of body fat in a week or two. So that is just something to be very, very mindful of. But going back to what reverse dieting really is, it's pretty much the opposite of prep. It's undoing prep. So like I said, just like you're gradually lowering your food intake and you're gradually increasing your energy output or your cardio, you're going to do the exact same thing in a reverse diet. You're going to gradually increase food, gradually introduce new foods, and gradually lower your cardio. So as I said, you cannot just shock the body because it is used to what it is doing. So you need to implement those changes gradually. So the first place I want to look at is food. As I said, calories need to be brought up slowly, A, to not shock the body, and B, your caloric needs are now lower. Because you are at a lower body weight, your caloric needs are lower. So in order to increase your metabolism again, you need to introduce a higher amount of food gradually. So, you know, week by week. And what we usually do is we usually bump it up a nice touch. So go out of a deficit, straight onto maintenance for me. So we started, I think, about a 1600 calories. And then we increased it gradually. So like every week, adding like 100 calories. And your body has time to adapt to that. Bless him, fueling me for a chit chat.
You're welcome.
You're in your reverse diet too.
I'm in my reverse diet. See?
This is what we don't want in a reverse diet.
Excuse me.
I'm joking.
I just don't have a six pack anymore. I just ate.
There we go. Okay, go. Because I have a lot to get through here. But apart from just increasing your food intake gradually, something I really, really recommend doing is introducing new foods very, very slowly. So again, going back to prep, your body is just so flipping sensitive. You'll find a lot of people build up intolerances to foods in prep just because of how sensitive their digestive system is. Like for me, I never had a problem with oats, and suddenly in prep, I couldn't eat oats anymore. So that was something that was introduced gradually as well. And now I'm eating oats every day. But yeah, so introducing new foods. The main thing is digestion. Digestion for me post-show is such a massive, massive factor, especially being someone with IBS. But to be honest, it's any competitor, because your digestive system takes a massive hit in prep. So I like to introduce new foods slowly. So the first 3 weeks. So as I said, we're going into week 4 now post-show. So 3 weeks into my reverse diet, and I am still pretty much eating my prep foods. Still eating rice, still eating chicken, peanut butter, eggs, avocado. Nothing has literally changed. There is no food that has been reintroduced yet. Just because we've been experiencing really bad gut issues, which I covered in the previous video and this morning. And B, I know these foods sit well with me. They're satiating. That being the main thing. Apart from making sure they sit with your stomach, they're satiating. You know, in prep, you always opt for foods that will somewhat fill you, or fill you the most they can. And that is also something you want to be doing post-show, because hormones. You have two hormones in your body. One is called ghrelin and one is called leptin. Now, don't forget these two names. They are the most important hormones in your reverse diet because they control your hunger. So leptin is a hormone stored in your fat cells. And this is the hormone that in a normal functioning body decreases appetite or tells you when you're full. Now on the other hand, your hormone ghrelin, which is actually stored in your stomach in a normal functioning body, increases appetite. So it tells you when you're hungry. So leptin tells you when you're full. Ghrelin tells you when you're hungry. No, it doesn't, because you've just completed a bodybuilding prep and your hormones are completely out of whack. You are always hungry and never full. And this is why controlling your diet should be your number one priority post-prep. As mentioned earlier, if you go on a mad one and just eat everything because you're constantly hungry, which you're going to be, a lot of the times you're going to be hungrier now than you were in prep. If you go on a mad one and just eat everything because you're always hungry, you're going to pack on a lot of weight. Your digestive system will suffer massively. And this is no place to be starting your off season, because you're going to be at a higher body weight than you wanted to be starting. You're not going to feel good. You're not going to perform well in your sessions. So the key factor post show for me for at least 3 weeks is food, digestion, making sure I am sticking to my meal plan 100%. Yes, obviously the day post show or the night post show, we go out, we enjoy our food, and that is completely fine. But the main thing is you need to hop onto your reverse diet straight away. And now if you have a good coach, he will make sure that that diet is there waiting for you in your tracker, either the night of the show or the morning after, and no later than that, because competitors need that sense of security. They need that plan to fall back on. And trust me, I've been there in the past. I've taken a whole week off after the show, and A, my digestion was horrible. B, I put on a little too much body weight than I wanted to. And C, I just couldn't get back on plan then. It was too long for me to be off plan, and I just couldn't get back on plan. I fell back into my binge eating habits and all of that shit. And just one more thing with regards to food, and as I said, introducing new foods gradually. Same thing goes with off-plan meals. As I said, go out, enjoy your post-show meal, get back onto your diet, and then I do recommend not having any off-plan meals or cheat meals or whatever you want to call them. I don't like calling them cheat meals. You're not cheating on anybody. I do like to hold off on them. A, to make sure that I can start increasing my food intake from my meal plan, and I am in a place where I can, you know, every week be adding those 100, 200 calories. Whereas if I start having off plans straight away, my average caloric intake for the week will be higher, and it just might leave no room to be increasing foods on the daily. So I do like to hold out on having off plans, and just from the point of digestion, because I just know that I never feel my best after an off plan meal. And the thing about reverse dieting and being post show, being so sensitive and so emotional, you just want to feel good. And this happens through fueling your body, really taking care of yourself, and resting. And that is something I want to get onto now from food, is training. So A, cardio needs to come down. I know you might think by doing extra cardio, you're going to be able to eat more food, but trust me, you're just going to be wrecked. Your body is just so tired right now. It needs to be refueled. It needs to rest. Cardio needs to come down. Now, I wouldn't be going from an hour to like no cardio straight away. Keep that cardio in there. Like, we're doing 6x20 right now, which is so doable. It wakes me up in the morning, it makes me feel good, and it just gives me something to do in the morning. So I still get up, I still stick to my normal routine. That is also a massive, massive factor. Stick to your routine. You have spent weeks and months being a very strict regime with your routine. You know, getting up at the same time every day, doing your cardio, prepping your meals, going to work, going to the gym at the same time, blah, 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 the list goes on. Don't change that. You've spent months building those habits. Don't let them go to waste. Just because you're off prep now doesn't mean you shouldn't be sticking to a routine. As I said, I still get up in the morning. I still do my cardio. Now, I don't have to be doing an hour anymore or 2 hours, which is amazing. But I still have that 20 minutes in and I still get ready. I go to work. I go to the gym at the same time every day. I eat my meals at the same time every day, making sure I'm optimizing digestion by keeping that meal timing where it should be. And that's pretty much it in terms of cardio. And training, that will depend on your coach. What I like to do, and what we have done every single year, and it works an absolute treat, I am given about a week or two to just train how I like. I go into the gym, no plan, I do whatever I feel like doing. You know, if there's exercises I missed doing that I didn't have in my plan for a long time, or if I don't want to do certain exercises, I just don't do them. And on a day where I just don't feel like training, or I feel like my body is tired and needs a rest, I take an extra rest day. I actually took 3 rest days last week when my digestion was so bad, and it helped. So yeah, implement that new plan slowly as well. Like, take your time, fall back in love with training. That is a massive thing, because let's face it, at the back end of prep, you don't like training anymore. Going to the gym is just another box that needs to be ticked off, and you're not enjoying it. So take the time to find your love for training again, because if you are a competitor, you love training. And it shouldn't be any other way. You compete because you train. You don't train because you compete. And if you do, you've got your priorities wrong, and maybe you shouldn't be competing. Obviously, there is a couple more bits that kind of go into reverse diet, like blood work. You do want to make sure your blood work is in check before making any changes. Do give yourself a couple of weeks because your hormones are going to be out of whack. You want to give them some time to naturally stabilize before getting your bloods done. Because trust me, if you get your bloods done like a week or 2 weeks post-show, they're just not going to be an accurate representation of where your health markers are actually at. And another thing I would recommend is really taking care of your mind and your mindset. Finding some strategies that will help you get your emotions out, because you are going to be in an emotional mess. You know, the goal of stepping on stage is done. There is no set date where you're going to be on stage again, possibly. You know, your focus shifts from getting as lean as possible to seeing the lines fade, seeing body fat go up, and it can be very, very challenging on the mind. I know it is for me. You know, I do like being lean. I love the look of myself lean, and because I just know how much work went into looking that lean, I'm always very sad to let it go. Especially the last 2 years. So this is kind of going to tie into this reverse versus the last. You know, I packed on weight fast. I never got time to enjoy being lean, whereas now I do, because I'm still somewhat in a very clean position. Even with the GI issues and the weight shooting up a touch, I'm still in a very, very good position. I'm lean, but I'm full and I'm strong and I'm really enjoying it. But that doesn't mean it's easy on the mind, letting the lines go. Something I do recommend, something I did last prep, or last post show and this post show is journaling. I have a little journal. It's called Know Your Power by Julie Renee. And it asks you simple questions in the morning, like, what will make today good? How do you want to show up today? What are your three priorities today? What are you grateful for today? What could trip you up from, you know, staying true to your goals? It literally takes me 5 minutes in the morning, 5 minutes in the evening, and it just really, really helps me get those emotions out on paper. So let's just focus on this post show versus my previous post shows. This post show has been very different. I am very proud of myself where it is. The mindset is stronger than it's ever been. Like, even with all those issues that we've had with my gut, like, I was in and out of the doctors, I was on laxatives, I was on meds, I was doing 24-hour fasts. Easiest thing to do, and something that was in the back of my mind, I'm not gonna lie, is listen, my stomach can't get any worse, I might as well eat whatever I want. But I didn't. I stuck to my plan 100%. I didn't go a gram over or under food. I wasn't emotional eating, I wasn't binge eating, and it has been 3 weeks. I've been dealing with hunger extremely well, to the point where it's actually settling now. And I do think this is because we haven't changed my food sources. I'm literally eating the same meals I was eating on prep in higher volumes, higher quantities, and I genuinely feel good. Training has been going better and better every single session. I'm getting strong again, and this is where my focus has been shifting, you know, from trying to get lean to getting strong and growing a nice pair of glutes, because that's what I need. So this post prep has been very, very different. Obviously, we are not out of the woods yet. It's only 3 weeks. We still have about 3 weeks to go. And that kind of brings me on to how long does it take? It's very dependent. It could take 6 weeks, 4 weeks, 8 weeks, 12 weeks. I know from past experience, it takes me about 12 weeks until I get to a point where I eat a meal and I'm like, I'm satisfied. I'm not hungry anymore. We're still not at that stage. You know, I'm still at the stage where I eat a meal and I can eat it again. But that's where the discipline needs to kick in. And listen, you ate your meal, you move on. The next one will come when it's time. You are not allowed to eat anything else on top of this. This is your food plan, and just like in prep, you're going to stick to it. So that's the biggest tip that I can give you, is treat your post show like you would your prep. Look at your post show, look at your reverse diet as an extension of your prep. Don't think just because the show is done, you're off prep. You're still on prep until your body stabilizes, until you and your coach agree that it's time to start moving things up. So like I said, bring down cardio gradually, increase food gradually, bring in new foods gradually, introduce that balance gradually. So today is day one for me. We are going out for our first meal out with my family. 3 weeks, nearly 4 weeks post prep. We're going for afternoon tea, we're going to the Christmas market, and we're going out for dinner. But the main thing is that I need to be able to hop back, straight back to my meal plan, to my cardio plan and training plan tomorrow 100%. This is the biggest mistake and my biggest setback in my previous post shows, is I'd enjoy a day off, but it would never just be one day. I'd struggle to get back on track and it would turn into a week, and sometimes it would get to a point where there was no turning back. So the main focus for this weekend is, and for today, is A, to make memories, enjoy some balance in this crazy life, but be back on plan tomorrow. Because if I mess this post show up again, I honestly don't think I'll be able to call myself a bodybuilder anymore. I don't think I would feel confident to call myself a bodybuilder, because it's gone far beyond that. I cannot be relying on food for emotional support. I want to be a bodybuilder. I want to be a IFBB bikini pro, and this is the mindset that I need to become one. Apart from obviously making some gains in the gym, the mindset is what needs the biggest transformation, and I feel like I'm on a very, very good path. I've just been feeling very content. I'm very proud of myself for how I managed my gut issues and how I managed to, you know, keep the head screwed on and just keep ticking the boxes and believe the process. Trust the process. That is the biggest thing you can do. You know, you have your coach there for a reason. He knows what to do, and make sure you communicate with your coach how you feel, what you need help with, because they are there to help you and make this process as easy on you as possible. The last thing I want to talk about is things not to do in a reverse diet. And obviously this will relate to food. It's things you see competitors doing. It's things I've done in the past. And they just lead you down a very, very dangerous road. First of all is ordering a load of cookies. Listen, it's okay to enjoy a cookie or two show day, post show. But if you start ordering a shit ton of cookies, like my first prep, I think I ordered from like 3 different cookie places. And yes, the cookies tasted amazing post show. But guess what? They were still in my house when I came back from the shows. And what did I do with them? Obviously, I ate them all. Yeah. So hoarding food and buying a lot of food is definitely not a good idea. It's something I've done in the past. And, you know, it's nice to enjoy a thing or two. But then all of that is still in your house. It's staring at you. And as I said, you're always hungry. You're never full. Cravings are through the roof. And trust me, if the food is there, you're probably going to give in. Unless you're the strongest individual I know mentally. And you have that self-discipline. I know me, if that food is there, I will either reach for it or it's just going to make my life really difficult because I'm just going to be thinking about it nonstop. So if you know you don't want to be eating certain things post-show or you're scared you're going to eat them, just don't keep them in the house. Don't buy them. And especially not in large quantities. So hoarding food, ordering cookies, no, just don't do it. You know, order a few cookies if you want to, bring them to your shows, share them with your friends and family, but make sure they are not stacked up in your freezer because you are going to eat them. And, you know, I know people that would literally even eat them frozen because you just can't control yourself. Like you become so vulnerable that something that sounds so weird, but so normal to some people, like, you know, there's a cookie in your freezer, just don't eat it. It's not that simple for us. So take care of yourself, take care of that hunger, take care of those cravings, and just don't go hoarding food because it will never, never bring you to a good spot. It's going to make things more difficult and you really don't want to be making this process any more difficult than it needs to be. And I think the biggest tip that I have for you is, as I said earlier, just go out, enjoy your food post show, and just hop straight back onto a plan the next day or the day after. Don't be giving yourself a whole week, because that week usually turns into a month or sometimes a place of no return. I've been there, I've done that, and it was the worst idea. Like this year, I enjoyed my food. If it was a late show, I'd enjoy my food like at the end of the day. If it was an early show, I'd, you know, kind of get the rest of the day fairly flexible, eating whatever I want, and then it would be straight back onto plan the next day. And my body has definitely thanked me for it because I still look good, I feel good, the digestion issues are settling. And, you know, this could also be linked to my blood work, which I'm still waiting to receive. So, yeah, we're going to leave it here. Just to summarize, reverse dieting is pretty much undoing prep. And it needs to be done gradually. It needs to be done slowly. Foods need to be introduced slowly and gradually. Balance will come in your life. You know, once you get past these 6 to 8 weeks to 12 to however long it will take you, you are really going to enjoy your off season. You're going to have that balance there. You're going to be eating a lot of good food and you're going to be able to go out for off plan meals, and your normal calories will be a lot higher than you think you can get them up to. And your performance in the gym, and you're just going to love the process. But if you kind of go off the rails post show, you pack on a load of weight, you're never going to bring your calories up. You're probably going to have to go into another mini cut. And, you know, going into mini cuts soon after prep is A, not good for your health, and just not good for the head because you're probably not going to pull through. So what I want to say is, to conclude this section of the video, is treat your reverse diet like an extension of your prep. Give it those few weeks, whatever the body needs, and everything will settle and life is going to be enjoyed to the max. And as I said, we are starting today. 3 weeks of being on my meal plan 100% is the reason that I can go into this off plan today with a calm mind, not stressed about eating food, not scared of eating food, because I know it won't do much damage, especially if I just hop back to my plan tomorrow, which I will. So I hope this made sense. If you have any more questions relating to reverse dieting, make sure you do pop it in the question in the comments below, and I will make sure to either answer or make another video if there is demand for it. So we're gonna leave this here and we're going to pick out some clothes to wear. I still don't know what I'm wearing. I'm gonna show you once I figure it out. The thing is, there's literally a weather warning today for wind. The one day Olivia gets to dress up and go into town, There's the weather warning. But you know what? I've been cold all prep. I can handle a bit of cold today, but look good. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to get dressed up and we're going to enjoy a day with the family. No guilt, no stress, no fear, and hop straight back on to plan tomorrow. Because I think it's 2 weeks to Christmas. It is 2 weeks to Christmas. Jesus. That is definitely something I'm going to talk about in the next video. Christmas, so close to post show. Scared, but excited. So, yeah, we're going to wrap this up here and I will catch you in a little bit.
Alrighty, we are ready. I feel so good. I couldn't find a proper setup here, so we have a little dress. And out of all the days, no stomach issues. There couldn't be a more perfect day. But yeah, black tights because it's cold. I'm wearing just some black Timberland boots and a blazer and makeup on point. Stage jewelry. And I feel really, really good. So yeah, we're gonna wait for the rest of the family and we're gonna head into town.
In there.
Are we ready to get some food in? Look at my pretty mommy. Yeah. Thank you.
That's a birdcage.
So cute.
Okay, for drink, do you want something?
So we've got a platter each. Sandwiches. Into desserts. And into scones. Mom, is this your first afternoon tea?
Yeah, it's my first time. I'm so excited.
We're experienced.
Can I start to eat now?
Wait for your tea.
We're still waiting on teas because apparently they have so many teas that she forgot what they have, but very excited for it. Let me lift it up. She's heavy. Very excited for this. I'm probably not going to give you any taste test. Okay, everybody is already eating. What are you eating?
I don't even
You're
know.
Starting with dessert.
Well, that was down there.
No.
It's creamy.
It's like cheese.
I see it.
It's like cream cheese.
Lemony stuff. And then this is like
slow down.
Pastry.
Oh, wow.
It's like a macaroon except hollow.
Yeah, so we've got some ham and cheese, I think. There should be a chicken one somewhere.
We've got turkey. Yes.
Do you know what? I've never had a mince pie, so today's the day I try a mince pie. And the best part for me is always the scones. You're not a bodybuilder unless you bring your own peanut butter everywhere.
Always.
Always.
Piping up.
What did you get?
We're working through it. Successful mission indeed. Absolutely demolished. On to the next.
So some left.
Olivia has cheesecake.
Do you want this?
Well,
no point letting it go to waste, is it, John?
She's not going to have it.
No. We don't want to starve our kids in Africa.
Exactly.
Yeah. One boy.
Thank you.
Good morning, YouTube. It is the next day. Yesterday was absolutely incredible. We had the most amazing day with my family. Obviously, you saw the afternoon tea. Then I didn't show you any of the market because it was so crowded. We literally couldn't even walk through. I then got a coffee in Starbucks, one of the Christmas coffees, my first Christmas coffee of the year. What else did we do? We did go to a little bakery, however, we actually didn't get anything. Well, we got the little gingerbread, we got them as a present, but we actually never even had them. And then we went to dinner, which was incredible. So I got a soup to start, chicken noodle soup, and then I got a satay, because what else do you get? I got a satay with rice noodles and yeah, and then we were still kind of hungry, so we actually stopped in Tesco on the way back. We got a few snacks. I know I didn't show you that. Got a little bit of chocolate, got a little bit of popcorn, and yeah, we probably shouldn't have because that's what hurt our stomachs the most at the end of the day. But listen, A, it was worth it. Yes, I'm a little bloated today. Weight is up 2.7 kilo, but I know, well, it's gonna settle back down tomorrow. We are back on plan today with some egg whites and avocado. I'll show you. Yeah, got an egg, but egg whites, veggies, avocado. And we are 100% back on plan today, the both of us. We're both in a little bit of pain. Come on here. We're both in a little bit of pain.
Yeah, I feel like shit.
We feel like shit. I actually don't feel like shit too much. It's just my stomach hurts a little bit, but that's I think we know by now that's a norm for me if I eat anything off plan. To be honest, my stomach was a bit iffy after the afternoon tea already, just because dairy, I'm a little bit intolerant to dairy. So, but as I said, it was so worth it. We made incredible memories and it was just so nice to actually be able to go out and do normal people stuff after prep again with my family. So it was a really good day. But as I said, straight back to plan today. I've got posing clients in the gym, the usual buzz. So I just want to say thank you so much for watching. I hope you found the reverse dieting part of the video somewhat informative and helpful. And I hope you enjoyed coming along with us for a bit of food yesterday. So thank you so much for watching. Make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, comment, share with a friend. Head over to Instagram, follow me there, and I shall see you in the next one. Ciao!